Hello! Today I'm going to talk about how to get into the game without paying too much tuition. Let me sit down and put my mic on. Well, there's a lot of people want a better sound. And better sound means better than what you can buy from Best Buy and Walmart and those kind of places. And don't know how to get about it, and not even get into the audiophile level things, and don't even try to get into audiophile because audiophile is an obsession. It's a slightly mental disorder. If you get into real audiophile things, it get crazy. So for the normal people, they're trying to get better sound, better than your clock radio and stuff like that. There are many ways to do it, but there are also many ways to waste money. I would say, let's start the don't first. How's that? Don't spend money at the first things that you heard that you think it sounds good. Most likely they actually don't. They sound excited. They get you excited, like going into Costco or Best Buy and look at the TV, and they turn on the brightest video that they can find. They're mostly graphics, mostly a short clip of 5 seconds or even less, and show you the vivid graphic they have. They try to draw your attention to the TV. Audio is the same thing. They try to draw your attention of the sound. And like trade show, happens all the time at trade show, less in the store, because you can have multiple audio system running, but you can have multiple TV running that doesn't interfere with each other. But when you go to the trade show, I might be jumping ahead of myself, but when you go to trade show, you have only 5 seconds to 15 seconds to catch attention of the attendee. If you don't catch attention in that 15 seconds, you lose them. So you have to play something that get them excited. Same thing that when you walk in the store, if somebody's trying to show you something that you think it sounds really good in the first 30 seconds or minutes, just keep listening. Stop. Keep listening. Don't talk to salesmen. Don't let them talk to you, because they will try to talk to you too. Well, they're commission sales, they want to make money, and I don't blame anybody trying to make money, but you have to be aware of what you when you're being sold. And that sounds a lot of work, isn't it? No, it's not. The money is still in your pocket, so don't take it out. Well, actually, you don't have to take your money with your store, but if your money is in phone, that's a different story. But stop your urge of spending money the first time you walk into the store. So don't spend money the first time you heard something that you think it sounds good. That's not a good thing. That you're gonna pay tuition fee. I'm not gonna call it a mistake, because you go still buy something that works but doesn't sound really good. Now I'm talking about two-channel audio. Let me make it clear. Two-channel audio. Home theater may be different. Home theater. Think about it. Home theater. You watch a concert 2 hours. You watch a movie maximum 2.5-3 hours, and then you're done with it. Are you gonna watch it 3, 4, 5 movie in the same day? Not really. There might be some exception, but most people watch a movie, go to bed. But music's different. Two-channel music, especially, you play music. You can actually play music all day long. But if you have music system that actually excites you for the first 5 minutes, and then you try to kind of walk away, and don't want to do something else, that's not something you want. You want something that you can actually play in the background all day long. Now, then you some people are saying, like, how come audiophile sit in front of a speaker and listen to the speaker system, amps, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, sit there and listen to it for hours and hours and hours. That's a different story. That's a different thing. That's a different enjoyment. But when you first get into these hobbies, if I may say get into these hobbies, I don't even know that what's the hobby's name, but really it's buying something that sounds better to play your music. It's like you got a really so-so hammer, but you want to buy a better hammer because you want a hammer, you want your hand to handle the hammer nicely, so you buy a better system. Better system doesn't necessarily mean it's a lot more money. I can get into that. that's a tangent off from something else is modern equipment versus vintage equipment and anything else, that's another topic entirely. But today I am talking about how to get into the hobby without getting, lack of a better word, ripped off, okay? So you are going to walk into a store. If you have a city that actually have big enough store, you're lucky enough to live in a city, you have three or four of those stores, walk into all three or four of those before you actually decide to buy anything. Do not buy a single thing when you first time walk into a store. And see, they will spend time with you. But also, when you walk into a store, do not dress nicely. Dress respectfully, but not necessarily nicely. Okay, don't walk in there with flip-flop, I guess, but a holy t-shirt or something, and try to not smell. And just normal people walk in there, have absolutely no idea what they're looking at, just tell them, say, I want to buy something that sounds nicer than my clock radio, and see what they say. See, they will actually spend 15, 20 minutes with you. If they don't, walk out. That's not your store. But if they try to show you a $1,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 system, you can stand there or sit in there and listen. Don't spend any money. Common question will be, how much do you want to spend? You just say you don't know. Just say you don't know and see how they react. The good one will actually ask more questions. You may get frustrated, but try not to, because the more question they ask, the more they care about what you want. So you might just honestly say you don't know, but just you don't know. The nice one will actually keep asking questions. They don't necessarily want to sell things to you that day, but they want to understand you. Unless they might even ask you how big your room is, what kind of furniture, what kind of music you listen to, how loud you want to listen to. Do you listen to all day long? Do you don't listen to what kind of streaming service you on? All kind of questions they will ask you. It will likely overwhelm you. But feel free to say stop and backtrack and come again and your information overload and you might have to come back again. And if you feel that they are good enough, you can go back and have a list of questions and ask them again. That's how you get into these hobbies without getting ripped off. Sometimes it's not them that actually rip you off. Sometimes it's you try and jump in too fast and walk into the trap. So that would be a tuition free, nobody trying to get rip you off, but it's walk into the trap, a pothole, and twist your ankle, come back up and do it again. We all done that. That I call it tuition fee. I don't call it a waste of money. Because in order to get really crazy into this hobby, you have to somehow make some mistake. If you don't make any mistake, you don't learn. Very, very few people actually met totally honest people, and that doesn't exist, totally honest people, including me. I'm not totally honest. So you will never meet anybody totally honest and can teach you everything. And even though if they're trying to teach you everything they know, they don't have your hearing. You don't listen to the same thing. You don't listen the same. It's like when I was younger, I was in Hong Kong, many, 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 like hundreds of audio store, new and used equipment. You walk into those used equipment, you always get a three or four of the older guys that talk about this audio experience, and they will teach you things. They'll tell you what the experience is. Not necessarily they would try to teach you or force you to learn, but you would just sit down and start listening to what the experience is. Good or bad, suitable or not, that's their experience. And to me, a lot of times, that's they're full of themselves. I'm not going to say full of the other one, but full of themselves, because they truly believe of what they heard. It's good for them. That's what hobby is about. Like cars, you don't just go into cars and say, I want to be a car nuts. You look at the car and you love it and you fall into it. You try to find more information, and that's how you get into the car hobbies. Same thing as this, audio hobbies. I am the same. I was the same thing. And then I try to get more and more information, and then I get into this point. Now, okay, back into the rookie part of the department, rookie side of the thing. When you get into these hobbies, first of all, I think the third time is saying, now don't spend the money on the first thing that you thought it sounds good. As if you have friends that into this, or musician friends, that's actually useful, that they don't necessarily know the equipment, but they have ears. So you can ask them to join you for the next visit to the store, give you some advice on music and sound, not necessarily equipment. They might not know, they might know. And the second option is, if you have friends that are actually into these hobbies, I dare say, like myself, you can ask them for some advice. Their advice are always biased. My advice are biased because it's my opinion. Not necessarily works for you, not necessarily work for anybody else. So opinions are always biased. So advice, so take it with a pound of salt, not a grain of salt, pound of salt. Especially the one that are trying to make money from you. Tons of salt, okay? So don't drown yourself in salt water. But if you take advice from the friend that try not to make money from you, a grain of salt. But there are also friends that try to impress you. That's a pound of salt. So be aware. If friends that actually willing to lend equipment for you to try before you buy something, or before you buy something used, or before you buy something new, you can actually take that salt away from your cup. That's actually a good friend. I have lots of equipment, but fortunately for me, I guess that I have no friends or relative that actually into this, and not even semi into this, or even slightly interested in this. And I can set up like 10 systems in this house, and I can take down 8, and I still have 2 active systems, but nobody asked me to borrow any equipment. So don't start. At least my friend and relative, I don't have to worry about them because none of them are actually into it. So that's the second option you can have. If you have friends that are actually into this hobby, you can actually ask them to borrow equipment. If they're nice enough, they will show you. But sometimes the equipment is expensive or with sentimental value to them, they will not willing to lend you because they are afraid that you're going to break it. I can see that point. And on a newbie side point of view, you have to prove that you can take care of the equipment. Sometimes you just don't know how to take care of it, an accident happened unintentionally, but still broken. So you both have to be aware of that risk. And the third way to get into this hobby is maybe reading reviews. That's a totally different topic, and I am going to leave it for another video, because a lot, I'm not going to say most, I'm not going to say all, but a lot of nowadays online reviewers are there to make money. They want clicks, and you see those clickbaits, and when you watch a video, if you're new to it and don't know a lot of background, don't know a lot of technical background, you think they are telling the truth. And most likely they are telling the truth, but how much knowledge do they have in order to come up with that opinion? Again, pound of salt, tons of salt. It's opinion. It's not necessarily fact. So be aware of it. Now, I'm not trying to bash anybody, but if I do sound like bashing, that's too bad. But I'm trying to tell the new people that come into the hobby, be aware of all these things. They're mostly unintentionally trying to rip anybody off. But first of all, everybody have to make a living. They have to make money. Some of them are more desperate. Some of them are less desperate. But they all have to make a living. Or otherwise, why are they doing it? So it's up to you to choose who to trust. And you should not trust anybody 100%. And don't put all the eggs in one basket until you find somebody that you can really trust. And even then, that person is not going to be 100% honest. You don't have to trust me, but nobody is 100% honest in this world. Well, unless, that's exception, but I'm not going to go there. But there's something to do with intelligence. So If anybody can actually sell you audio equipment, they are not 100% honest. So just be aware of that. It's up to you to who you give your money to. If you want to buy something, you eventually have to give your money to somebody. That's basically, would that somebody support you after you sell, after you sold the stuff, after you bought the stuff? That's one thing. And that somebody, are they telling you the truth? Most likely they are. The problem is they are telling you the truth from their point of view, but is it suitable to you? That's for you to decide. So don't let anybody pressure you to buy something that you're not comfortable with. What it sounds good to you in the store, not necessarily sound good at home. Now, if it sounds good enough in several occasions with several different music, with different kind of combination, that's worth serious considering. But if it sounds good for the 5 minutes, just calm yourself down, walk away, go home, come back the next day or come back the next week, listen to a different music, bring your own music if you have any. If you only have MP3 on your phone, so be it. Bring it to the store. If your bad recording doesn't sound good on that system, don't buy it, because if music is more important than sound to you, then you have to bring your own music. And I don't care how badly recording your music is, it still has to be enjoyable. And that's why I design things like this, and this is not sellable. But I can guarantee you, I can put MP3 YouTube music on this system, it's enjoyable. Does it sound really good? Does it sound awesome? Hell no! But does it sound enjoyable? But yeah! Do I have to rate that hell in a caution level on YouTube? I don't know. I should have to remember that. Anyway, so be aware of what you're buying. But in the next video, I may get enough courage to tell you how to gauge reviewer online, on paper, that kind of things. But that's not really what you have to be concerned yet. And if you are really new in this, try not to actually just base on the how many star that has on that product and buy that, because all products have 3 or 4 or 4.5 star anyway. So star ratings are not necessarily good, and some of them are fake. Seriously, some of them are fake. I don't care where they come from, some of them are fake. So if you want to buy a product, try to find somebody that actually have that product, know that product. If you don't know anybody, walk in the store and actually try that product. Try the product yourself. There are factors other than sound, that how convenient it is, how easy to use. The more wireless the thing, the harder to use. And if it doesn't, does it hook it up to your phone? Personally, I don't want to hook up anything to my phone, because if I lost my phone, if I had my phone get hacked, the whole system get hacked, your whole house get hacked. So if I have a 2-channel system, I leave it alone. I don't hook it up on the net. I actually have music on a hard drive. If you want to stream it all by all means stream it. But rely on your phone as little as possible. That's my personal advice. Take it with a pound of salt. But I don't like to hook things up on the internet if I don't have to. So I'm going to end this video right there. And next time, I'm going to talk about how to gauge online reviewers, and how to find a or many or few reviewers that you can trust. And after that, your sale will be a little bit smoother. When you try to just get your feet wet the first time, it's always a little rough. Water's a little cold. So just hang on to your wallet. Don't spend a cent if you don't have to. That's my first advice to get into these hobbies. Until then, stay safe. I'm turning off the camera now. Bye.